Hey, happy Friday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Now, I have some potentially great news to share with you on what's going to happen with this potential, don't even want to say golf, hurricane, golf storm. Because this storm literally has one chance to make it, and the chance that it's going to make it is either going to be a tropical depression or a tropical storm. We're seeing a lot of weakness this morning. I'm not just talking about the weather models. I'm talking about the data. The MJO has weakened down greatly. Now, you can see the update for this morning. You can see all the precipitation starting to wrap around the Central American Gyre over here. But you also can see how far southern it is. Now, I'm going to show you the latest information that I found for you. And if it continues on this track this afternoon, we're really going to have a great news update. So far, I think it's great news already. Latest information from National Hurricane Center still has it at 40%, still the exact same information. But look at this. This is our MJO. This is all this favorable lift that was passing from the Pacific over our region. And now, from the 22nd on, we have a little bit of favorable environment moving through. Matter of fact, if you take a look at the favorable environment, this is the best chance on this phase for anything to happen. This is either do or die. Most of it is in the Pacific as it passes by for the beginning of October as well, going by Central America and the Eastern Caribbean. That is it. So let me break it down for you for those who are like, hey, I have no idea what you just said, Mark. So as we go all the way until the 24th of September, our MJO, all that lift passing across the Pacific, is coming towards our region. But look at this. It's really strong in the Eastern Pacific. Not for the Gulf of Mexico for this system, so it's not going to be doing anything during that time. When you go five more days, all the way to the 29th of September from the 24th, this is the only opportunity it has for any kind of formation. This is where it's going to get pulled by this trough of this system, showing it to be somewhere around the south. So that would be somewhere towards a northward pull. And then as it goes east, it could pull it a little bit towards the east, towards Mississippi, towards Alabama, far western panhandle of Florida. Those are the three options that I'm seeing. After that, because you can see most of the intensity is in the Eastern Pacific, not over here in the far southern Gulf of Mexico or the Western Caribbean. So it's not really the strongest that's going to be over here. It's going to be pulling more towards the Eastern Pacific. When you go five more days, bam, it just lost its opportunity to form. It literally has one chance. Now you can see the latest from the Euro, your chance for a tropical depression. It gets pushed to the west, still showing like my update last night that it's not northern enough, it's not strong enough neither to reach anywhere for this trough or any kind of direction getting pulled from the system or the trough towards the southeast. And you see the latest update shows it might get pulled that direction later. Now, if it does, once again, we're going to be talking about something very weak, very elongated, or just tropical moisture if it misses its one chance. Now, when you look with the latest with the ensembles, look at GFS. This is literally in 6 days, showing it to be a little more eastern and northern is where it's favoring. It has many locations, but this white area right here is where it's more favorable that it will form up. And look how it just gets really big and broad. Really big and broad. So in 6 days with the Euro, it's a little more southern and western. And as you go a little bit further, you can see it stays on that western track, staying right around here somewhere around the next 7 or 8 days, where it could either go north at this point, be something rather weak, or it'll go to the west. And you can see it better here. So as you go towards 5-6 days, you get a lot of strong favorability of formation, not only on the Western Caribbean, also right here in the Eastern Pacific. And as it goes 6-7-8 days away, right here is your opportunity. Right here is where you have your trough coming down, your storm system pulling it northern, and it either will go northern or go late and go northeastern and get pulled in that direction. If it does not make this small window, it will go west right afterwards. So it either has its small window to catch or it's going to go west. That's the two opportunities. It has literally one chance. Now, the latest on the Euro is still showing great news, just like last night. It's showing that high pressure block will be there, keep everything going in the west, and that trough coming through will not be able to interact with that wave because of that high pressure block. It has brought the block back, and there's nothing that could pull this system to the north anywhere. Maybe after it moves, it will get pulled out finally towards the east, be elongated, either a tropical depression or a very strong tropical depression, or just some Gulf moisture coming through. Showing chances for formation is favoring more into the eastern Pacific on multiple formations, not into the western Caribbean. Look how it just stays on that southern side because your MJO is stronger down here than it is up here. But still, you have your one little window and it is a weaker window. Look at this. Very weak and elongated. Remember what a shot we showed a long time ago where it showed multiple low pressures, elongated with the Euro. Even the AI picked up on that. We're starting to see that again. Elongation of tropical moisture. Matter of fact, let's take it a little bit further. Let's go to the Euro control member of the ensembles. What we could see next after potentially 10 days. And this shows that it will not make its chance. It will stay weak on the 8 to 9 days and then get pushed out to the west, missing its opportunity. Now, there is some differences. AI artificial of Euro is showing still has that one quick chance to make it through, and it's showing a tropical storm, a strong tropical storm, but you can take that a lot better than a strengthening hurricane. So it's showing it has that one opportunity. Remember, once we go from the 24th, this is where it gets pulled north all the way to the 29th, where it has a chance to make it. Showing a tropical storm on that one really quick. Now, when we go to the previous run, it showed almost the same thing, a little bit more strength. So we're seeing a little bit more weakness, a little bit more towards the eastward pull. So it's either going to be a strong tropical storm, a strong tropical depression, or just a lot of tropical moisture. I believe hurricane is off the table. Now you can see this when you look at your 500 millibar vorticity with the GFS. Showing that high pressure block will not be there because that trough will come on in and squeeze itself in. This will pull that system to the north literally right past 6 days. Still on this run, it shows it could pull it real quick and then this system heads north. And it's not pulling it no more. But you see where it has its open opportunity. It has that close, then it's open right there on the 26th to head north. But at the same time, that system is heading north. And I like to add that the Euro and GFS saw this over the Four Corners yesterday. The Canadian showed that this is going to come on in as a system and pull this into the Gulf a little bit. That is what we're seeing with the GFS as well now. And look at this. It pulls it. But then it loses it. It's not in hold of it at this point. So it just slowly meanders with the atmosphere. Then it grabs it again. So it's not pulling it very well at all. And then it finally pulls it on shore. So it's not getting a good hold of this system. It's pulling it a little bit. It's letting it go. It's pulling it a little bit. Now when this happens, you will have a counterclockwise system up here showing this if it was true. That this would be bringing a lot of shear on this counterclockwise system trying to grow from the west while this is trying to go west. So it would keep it pretty weak. And you can see this with the shear. So if that was a play out, you can see your system start headed north, your other system building up in lower 48, but it's starting to put a lot of shear on that system and it could not form up in that scenario. It would be something very weak and very sheared. Showing on the latest run that it does bubble up a lot more towards the eastern Pacific. And as we go towards 6 days, there it goes trying to do something. Now this run shows that it will be somewhat still a strengthening hurricane. Now when you go to the previous run, this is the 6Z. You got to remember 0Z and 12Z is balloon data runs. That's where a lot of meteorologists everywhere are putting up these weather balloons and they put all this information into these models. So those are more accurate. And the balloon data run shows what we're seeing with the Canadian and the Euro. That is multiple vortices, elongated system. Look at that, you even get a little Fujiwara going on. Multiple vortices and a very weak system, a tropical storm. You can see the same thing on the Canadian. It gets that one chance. It comes in. It pulls it. The Canadian is the only one that takes it bigger and broader before this comes. But you still see how it heads north and pulls it north. Look how elongated all of that is. Once again, here you go with the pressure of it. You can see how it's just elongated. You're starting to see multiple vortices dancing around with that system. That could bring multiple tropical systems at the same time, bring more of a flooding problem with all of this and impacting more people. So it still could be something. Look at that, multiple systems. Either way, that's better than a hurricane, but this would impact even more inland of the flooding. It would become a pretty good flooding threat. And to compare it with the icon, we can't quite go that far. It takes it within the next 4 to 5 days, a very low surface low, and then goes into the Yucatan. That's all we got so far on that. Even update on the GEOS. Look at this. Goes western, tries to form a tropical storm in the far southern Gulf of Mexico, and goes western, just like we've seen on a control model of the Euro. But thank you for your time, everybody. Hope this helps you understand what is going on in the tropics. I will keep you updated this afternoon. So far, we are seeing some good news, and I want to see more of this trend this afternoon. So I will see you this afternoon, and hopefully it does keep trending and it just gets weaker and more of a chance to just go west. Last thing anyone wants is a major hurricane, especially in this Gulf of Mexico. Now, before I go, real quick, Psalm 16:8-11. I have set the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. Therefore my heart is glad, and my glory rejoiceth. My flesh also shall rest in hope, for thou wilt not leave my soul in hell, neither wilt thou suffer thine holy one to see corruption. Thou wilt show me the path of life. In thy presence is fullness of joy. At thy right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I hope this brings some good news to you and your family. And we still have a chance for this to form up, but the percentage has gone way down greatly, I do believe. It literally has a very, very small window. So we will see what the update brings. Hopefully this keeps trending. And remember, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you this afternoon.